Hi, welcome to this video. In this video, I'm going to share the time-lapse version of this hummingbird painting. So if you want to know a little bit about how I approach this, I'm going to talk you through it. So let's get started. All right, so like my other videos, I will pretty much just talk you through the process of the painting, and hopefully it's helpful for you. So first of all, I was painting this hummingbird as part of the Paint With Me challenge, and that's just a free challenge I host every month where I pick a reference photo and everybody paints the same thing or paints from the same photo. And I think it's really fun to see how everybody's paintings turn out different depending on our own styles and our artistic interpretations. So I will link more about the challenge below so you can join us next month if you'd like. And the reference photo for this month is also listed below if you want to give this a try yourself. So the suggestion I gave in the email that went out with the challenge at the beginning of this month was to give this painting a try using wet on wet technique in a very particular way, which is not just wetting the front side of the paper, but it's completely soaking the paper on the front and the back. Or I guess you could dunk the paper in a tray of water, but basically the water has completely soaked the papers, and that's what's making it stick to this acrylic panel that I'm using. And that was the suggestion I gave to try this painting this month, because that's what I was going to do, and that is what I was guiding members inside of my community to do. And if you don't know about the community that I host, it's called Paint With Me, and the challenge is always going to be a extension of the Paint With Me community. So I will leave links below for the Paint With Me community as well below this video. But basically this month I guided the members inside of our community to try painting with this very wet approach. And the technique basically involves wetting both sides of the paper or just completely soaking it and then letting it stick to whatever surface you're using. I'm using this acrylic sheet and then painting on it. And it's quite tricky and it can feel a little bit out of control because the paper is so wet. So it requires learning about timing and about the different degrees of wetness of the paper because it's going to change as you continue working on the paper, because it's the paper is constantly continuing to dry as you work on it. And I've learned just through my own experience that the consistency of paint that I'm using, the consistency of paint that's on my brush, the wetness of my brush, basically it changes the results that I get on the painting, because the paper is wet and it's definitely reacting a certain way. And I just sometimes have to wait too. Sometimes I have to pull out my blow dryer, which I did for this painting, and dry it a little bit so I can keep working. Either that or I just have to wait. So I just think that this technique really gives you a lot of opportunities to create some beautiful soft effects. And then if you wait and you layer, you can get beautiful hard hard lines as well as dry brush textures, and it's just such a dynamic way to paint, and it's something that I'm personally exploring more. So to give you a few details about this painting, it's quite small. It's 4 inches by 4 inches, and I picked a square because the reference photo is sort of a square, so I just wanted to keep the proportions and then not have to deal with, you know, making up the parts of the painting that were out of the scope of the photo, if that makes sense. And so I kept it sort of the same format. And I'm painting pretty much from the reference photo, in the sense that the bird is in the same positioning, the same colors and everything like that. The branch and the berries are pretty much the same format. I did take creative liberty with the berries, so the berries aren't quite the same format. And then the background that I eventually paint here for this this painting, it doesn't match the reference photo. And the reason is because I wasn't quite sure how the colors would all mix together, and I was a little bit intimidated, is the best word for it. So I wasn't really sure how all of the different colors of the background were going to come together. So I decided to play it safe in my own way and just use sort of the same color family, as you'll see as you continue watching this video. So I just wanted to let you know those kind of few details as you're watching this time lapse. And other than that, I don't really have that much to share about the process, other than the fact that I painted on a wet piece of paper and did have to manage time a little bit as I was going. I did, and you're not seeing this in the video, but I did use a hairdryer at some points to speed up the process. But otherwise, that's really the approach I took with this. It was very experimental. I can't say I knew exactly where this was going to go, especially as I started into the background. I can say with pretty much 100% surety, is that a word? Sureness, that haven't approached the background this way. I tend to not paint backgrounds. I tend to just paint the subject. And so, well, I take that back. Unless I'm following a class where they paint the background first. But if you leave me to my own devices, then I tend to not paint backgrounds on paintings. And so this was definitely new for me. I'm basically painting the background sort of as a negative painting. I'm painting around the subject. I even painted around the tips of the tail. So it was a little bit of an adventure. I wasn't, like I said, I wasn't really sure what I was doing. I felt like it came out too light. I'm trying to add in branches to see what would happen. But ultimately, I just ended up going over these layers because I didn't feel like there was enough contrast. So I darkened the background and I played with it. And luckily, it didn't turn out too bad. And I think that what helped me was the fact that I was working really, really wet. And I didn't, I was afraid I was going to overwork it. And I actually was quite surprised that it didn't end up as overworked as I thought it was going to be. And I do think it's because of the dampness of the paper. So I'm really looking forward to continuing to explore this approach more. But I think it was so fun. And I ended up using a little bit of white gouache to bring out highlights too, just because I was just going with the flow. I wasn't overthinking it. I was just playing. And I think that there was something really fun about approaching the painting this way. And I think that's why I love, you know, just doing the challenges and experimenting and taking an opportunity to experiment and not actually know what I'm doing, which is why when I talk about this in this voiceover, I can't really give specific direction because I didn't approach it with a specific method. I just approached it in a really free way. And I am pleased with how it turned out, mostly because the process was fun. And I want to just say something about this as I'm here talking anyway, is that these time-lapse videos, they give all of us, and I mean, it's a good format, right, to share a time lapse, especially in our age of digital consumption, because it helps speed up the process. We can sort of watch it faster. But the reality is this, you know, 10, 11 minute video, it actually in real life took me almost an hour to paint the whole thing, you know, but with waiting time and drying time and just putting in details. And so I just wanted to add this note that, you know, I think we all watch a lot of time lapse, basically sped up videos, just, you know, in our own research when we're watching other artists paint and getting inspiration. But I think inadvertently it sort of sets a maybe unrealistic expectation for ourselves. Like we almost expect ourselves to paint quickly and to get it right and for it to seem flawless. But in between the speedy painting processes that we see are a lot of, you know, little pauses and mistakes and backtracking that aren't necessarily shown. And even if I showed you the full length version here, you might not want to watch the whole thing because it's a little bit too slow. But I just want to say that here is that, you know, the process took much longer than you're seeing as I'm talking to you here. And the time lapse helps hide a lot of mistakes. It helps things look a lot smoother than they really went. And so I just want to encourage you not to, you know, in your mind, set yourself up to impossible standards that are really hard to achieve. And also to enjoy the process, the slow process of painting, the methodical and the exploration and the curiosity and discovery that comes with painting with watercolors. So don't let this time lapse fool you. It took me a long time and I had fun with it. And so I hope if you give this a try, that you take your time and that you explore and that you have fun as well.